If a canary in a coal mine is the archetypical portent of impending peril, well, don't sleep on the American oyster catcher or the piping plover.
You know, there are a lot of species these days that are canaries in coal mines. And what's extraordinary is that we now know the interconnectivity and interdependencies that species have with humans and with the earth.
At Manomet Conservation Sciences in Plymouth, they've been tracking and banding migratory land and shorebirds since the organization's founding in 1969.
This bird takes a size 1 band.
Evan Dalton is director of land bird science and heads the banding lab.
This is excellent, a lovely bird. This is a bird called a northern water thrush. It's not a thrush, it's actually a wood warbler. It's got this nice lemony yellow wash on the throat and upper breast.
Many species migrate across vast distances. In the spring and summer, land birds move like an undulating tapestry en route from South and Central America north to the U.S. and beyond. Shorebirds also travel north along a narrow highway, a ribbon of species following the coastline. Lizzie Schuler is president of Manomet Conservation Sciences.
So here we have 55 plus years of data, information about what birds have come here, when, what they look like, how fat they are, when they arrive, when they leave, bird declines or bird increases.
The American oyster catcher and the piping plover, both near extinction in the last century, are seeing comebacks thanks to conservation efforts. Manomet played an important role in partnering with other conservation groups and since 2008 have seen a nearly 50% increase in the American oyster catcher population along the Atlantic and Gulf coasts. While Mass Audubon takes the lead with the piping plovers, they too are seeing a healthy rebound, with a record-setting number of nesting pairs last year in the Commonwealth. Plovers are still considered threatened or endangered. Oyster catchers are not.
And you can see here, I have his little band on his leg.
We're trying to help kids connect to nature, and particularly the nature that's here where they are.
Molly Jacobs is Manomet's VP of Environmental Outreach and Education.
We really want kids and teachers and their families to feel like they are stewards of the nature that's here. And so we really want to help them feel like they know nature and it's a place they're comfortable and familiar and feel connected to.
Indeed, seeing wildlife up close can have a transformative effect.
But I think birds are special, like they're really exciting for people. Birds connect us. Those same birds that was in our hands showing to those students, that bird a few weeks ago may have been in Texas or even in Central America getting ready to migrate.
And perhaps a visit here will convince these students to migrate toward a broader understanding of the natural world.
Our hope is that they grow up to be good conservation partners and help work with us to protect the world that we care so much about.
The work that we do more and more is about human behavior. It's not really about bird behavior. It's about understanding the birds, but then influencing people and humans to realize the importance of places where they are and the need for joint solutions and collaboration to ensure that we don't decimate some of these populations.
Scientists say that birds are a very good indicator of ecosystem health. Generally, if you have diverse and abundant bird species in a region, it's a sign you have good water quality, plenty of nesting space, and plentiful food sources as well. And we want to send our condolences to the good people at Manomet Conservation. Not long after our visit, one of their shorebird researchers, Shiloh Schulte, died in a helicopter crash in Alaska. He was on his way to conduct additional tracking of migratory shorebirds, a passion he pursued throughout his scientific career.